Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's your girl Fanny Lungu, back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. A big shout out to the person that suggested this, and a big shout out to the people that have subscribed to our channel so far. Thank you for subscribing, liking, commenting, sharing, watching. Everything that you guys do, we're grateful, and just thank you. So today I'm going to be reacting to the whole story of Yusuf A from the Quran, episode 2 of 2. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
The king said, "Bring him to me. I will select him exclusively for my own service." So when Joseph spoke to him, the king said, "You are now one of established position, fully trusted by us." Joseph said, "Place me in charge of the treasures of the land. I am a good keeper and know my task well." Thus did we establish Joseph in the land so that he could settle wherever he pleased. We bestow favor out of our mercy on whomsoever we please, and we do not cause the reward of those who do good to go to waste. Surely the reward of the hereafter is better for those who believe and act in a God-fearing way." And Joseph's brothers came to Egypt and presented themselves before him. He recognized them, but they did not know him. And when he had prepared for them their provisions, Joseph said, "Bring to me your other brother from your father. Do you not see that I give full measure and am most hospitable? If you do not bring him to me, you shall have no corn from me, and do not even attempt to come close to me." They said, "We will surely try to prevail over our father to send him. Be sure we shall do so." And Joseph said to his servants, "Put surreptitiously in their packs the goods they had given in exchange for corn." Joseph did so, expecting that they would find it when they returned home. Feeling grateful for this generosity, they might be inclined to return to him. When they returned to their father, they said, "Father, we have been denied further supply of corn. So send with us our brother that we may bring the supplies. We shall be responsible for his protection." The father said, "Shall I trust you with regard to him as I had trusted you earlier with regard to his brother? Allah is the best protector and is the most merciful." And when they opened their things, they found that their goods had been given back to them. Thereupon they cried, "Father, what else would we desire? Look, even our goods have been given back to us. So we shall go now and bring supplies for our family. We shall protect our brother and bring another camel load of corn. That additional supply will be easily secured." Their father said, "I shall never send him with you until you give me a solemn promise in the name of Allah that you will bring him back to me, unless you yourselves are surrounded." Then after they had given him their solemn promise, he said, "Allah watches over what we have said." And he enjoined them, "My sons, do not enter the city by one gate. Rather, enter it by different gates. I can be of no help to you against Allah. Allah's command alone prevails. In Him have I put my trust, and in Him should all those who have faith put their trust." And it so happened that when they entered the city by many gates, as their father had directed them, this precautionary measure proved ineffective against Allah's will. There was an uneasiness in Jacob's soul which he so tried to remove. Surely he was possessed of knowledge owing to the knowledge that we bestowed upon him. But most people do not know the truth of the matter. When they presented themselves before Joseph, he took his brother aside to himself and said, "Verily, I am your own brother, Joseph, so do not grieve over the manner they have treated you." Then while Joseph was having their provisions loaded, he put his drinking cup in his brother's saddlebag. And then a herald cried, "Travelers, you are thieves." Turning back, they asked, "What have you lost?" The official said, "We have lost the king's cup." And their chief added, "He who brings it shall have a camel load of provisions. I guarantee that." They said, "By Allah, you certainly know that we did not come to act corruptly in this land, nor are we those who steal." The official said, "If you are lying, what will be the penalty for him who has stolen?" They replied, "He in whose saddlebag the cup is found, he himself shall be its recompense. Thus do we punish the wrongdoers." Then Joseph began searching their bags before searching his own brother's bag. Then he brought forth the drinking cup from his brother's bag. Thus did we contrive to support Joseph. He had no right, according to the religion of the king, for instance, the law of Egypt, to take his brother unless Allah so willed. We exalt whomsoever we will over others by several degrees, and above all those who know is the one who truly knows. They said, "No wonder that he steals, for a brother of his stole before." But Joseph kept his reaction to himself without disclosing the truth to them. He merely said to himself, "You are an evil lot. Allah knows well the truth of the accusation that you are making against me, to my face." They said, "O powerful chief, Al-Aziz, his father is an age-stricken man, and in order that he may not suffer, seize one of us in his stead. We indeed consider you an excellent person." Joseph said, "Allah forbid that we should seize any except him with whom we found our good. Were we to do so, we would surely be one of the wrongdoers." Then when they had despaired of Joseph, they went to a corner and counseled together. The eldest of them said, "Do you not know that your father has taken a solemn promise from you in the name of Allah, and you failed in your duty towards Joseph? So I will not depart from this land until my father permits me, or Allah pronounces his judgment in my favor. He is the best of those who judge. So go back to your father and tell him, 'Father, your son has certainly been guilty of stealing. We did not see him stealing, but testify according to what we know. And obviously, we had no power to keep watch over what is altogether hidden from us. You may inquire of the dwellers of the city where we were, and of the people of the caravan with whom we traveled. We are altogether truthful in what we say.'" The father heard the narration and said, "All that is untrue, but your souls have made it easy for you to engage in a heinous act. So I will be graciously patient even at this. Allah may well bring them all back to me. He is all-knowing, all-wise." Then he turned his back to them and said, "Oh, my grief for Joseph." His eyes whitened with grief, and he was choked up with sorrow, trying to suppress his grief. The son said, "By Allah, you will continue to remember Joseph until you will either consume yourself with grief or will die." He said, "I will address my sorrow and grief only to Allah, and I know from Allah what you do not know. My sons, go and try to find out about Joseph and his brother, and do not despair of Allah's mercy. Verily, only the unbelievers despair of Allah's mercy." On going to Egypt, they presented themselves to Joseph and said to him, "O chief, we and our family are struck with distress and have brought only a paltry sum. So give us corn in full measure, and give it to us in charity. Allah rewards those who are charitable." When Joseph heard this, he could not hold himself and said, "Do you remember what you did to Joseph and his brother when you were ignorant?" They exclaimed, "Are you indeed Joseph?" He said, "Yes, I am Joseph, and this is my brother. Allah has surely been gracious to us. Indeed, whoever fears Allah and remains patient, Allah does not allow the reward of such people to go to waste." They said, "We swear by Allah, indeed Allah has chosen you in preference to us, and we were truly guilty." He replied, "No blame lies with you today. May Allah forgive you. He is the most merciful of all those that are merciful. Take this shirt of mine and throw it over my father's face. He will regain his sight and bring to me all your family." And as the caravan set out from Egypt, their father said in Canaan, "Indeed, I smell the fragrance of Joseph. I say so although you may think that I am doting." They said, "Surely you are still in your same old craze." And when the bearer of good news came, he threw Joseph's shirt over Jacob's face, whereupon he regained his sight and said, "Did I not tell you that I know from Allah what you do not know?" They said, "Father, pray for the forgiveness of our sins. We were truly guilty." He said, "I shall pray to my Lord for your forgiveness, for he, and indeed he alone, is ever forgiving, most merciful." And when they went to Joseph, he took his parents aside and said to the members of his family, "Enter the city now, and if Allah wills, you shall be secure." And after they had entered the city, Joseph raised his parents to the throne beside himself, and they involuntarily bowed in prostration before him. Joseph said, "Father, this is the fulfillment of the vision I had before, one that my Lord has caused to come true. He was kind to me when he rescued me from the prison and brought you from the desert after Satan had stirred discord between me and my brothers. Certainly my Lord is subtle in the fulfillment of his will. He is all-knowing, all-wise." My Lord, you have bestowed dominion upon me and have taught me to comprehend the depths of things. O Creator of heavens and earth, you are my guardian in this world and in the hereafter. Cause me to die in submission to you, and join me in the end with the righteous. O Muhammad, this is part of the news from the unseen that we reveal to you, for you were not present with them when Joseph's brothers jointly resolved on a plot. And most of the people, howsoever you might so desire, are not going to believe. You do not seek from them any recompense for your service. This is merely an admonition to all mankind. How many are the signs in the heavens and the earth which people pass by without giving any heed?
I love this story, and I should say this story is actually one of the saddest to come across. Like I said in the part one, that sometimes it's those closest to you that are going to want your downfall even more than your enemies. And it's just a crazy, crazy world. At the end of the day, we're being taught that even if people do you wrong, always be kind to them, treat them with good intentions, just don't lose yourself because someone wronged you in the past. Be a better person, be a bigger person, and see things in a more better perspective, and life gets easier once you're no longer upset over something that happened in the past, because then you're freely able to move on and see things differently. Let me know what you guys understand from this. I mean, there's no justifying what they did to him, but God blessed him in the end. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video. When I think about you.